After the rabbi of Chabad Lubavitch, Rabbi Menachem Mendel Schneerson, started his Noahide campaign in the 1980s, the number of Gentiles willing to keep the seven laws of Noah, as described in the Torah, increased. The seven laws of Noah were recognized by the United States Congress in the preamble to the 1991 bill that established Education Day in honor of the birthday of Rabbi Menachem Mendel Schneerson. The second law of the seven Noahide laws, as listed by the Mishnah in Sanhedrin 56, is prohibition of blasphemy. You shall not curse the name of Yahweh. In his book Reconsiderations, British historian Arnold J. Toynbee writes on page 486, Judaism is a development of the pre-exilic religion of Judah that was created in, and by, the Babylonian diaspora and was imposed by it on the Jewish population in Judea. There has also been the aim of converting the Gentile world to the worship of Yahweh, under the aegis of a world empire centered on Eretz Israel, and ruled by the Lord's anointed, a coming human king of Davidic lineage. Yahweh is the God of the Old Testament, the Hebrew Torah, and the God of Israel. And if Jesus of Nazareth attempted to create a new covenant with God, a New Testament, Jesus then subsequently being executed for blasphemy against Yahweh, why would Christians worship Yahweh, God of the Torah, Old Testament, as their God? Jesus of Nazareth was of the Nazarene sect, and spoke Aramaic. In the Aramaic Bible, John 13:19, Jesus says, "Now I am telling you before it happens, that when it has occurred, you shall believe that I am the living God." Rabbi Martin Siegel, who in New York Magazine, January 18, 1972, page 32, states, "I am devoting my lecture in this seminar to a discussion of the possibility that we are now entering a Jewish century, a time when the spirit of the community, the non-ideological blend of the emotional and rational, and the resistance to categories and forms will emerge through the forces of anti-nationalism to provide us with a new kind of society. I call this process the Judaization of Christianity, because Christianity will be the vehicle through which this society becomes Jewish."
The following footage is of Rabbi Menachem Mendel Schneerson ordering Israeli President Benjamin Netanyahu to hasten the arrival of the Jewish Messiah.
אז הייתה שם משהו, אם מה הביאתו?
ועושים, עושים.
כנראה שהיא מספיק, כאילו שהיום כבר שוד, כמה שוד התבגר עדיין ליבו. אבל יש עוד כמה שוד, שעות, אבל יש להשתדל גם היום. נכון. ובשורות טובות. נכון. זה שמחה וטוב לראות. אז כדי שחסידים מתפילים שכל מיני מנויים את השמחה.
For you, brothers, became followers of the churches of God which in Judea are in Christ Jesus, for you also have suffered, like things of your own countrymen, even as they have of the Jews, who both killed the Lord Jesus and their own prophets, and have persecuted us, and they please not God, and are contrary to all men. 1 Thessalonians 2:16.
Oh, my God.
Why does the prophet Moses have two horns on his head?
Moses was a gray, bearded wise man who brought the Ten Commandments of God in the Hebrew Torah and Old Testament down from Mount Sinai. Canaan was a Semitic-speaking region in the ancient Near East, roughly corresponding to the Levant, i.e. modern-day Israel, Palestinian territories, Lebanon, and the western parts of Jordan and Syria.
For the Canaanites, El, or El-El, was the supreme god, the father of mankind and all creatures. His sons were Hadad, Ram, and Mot. Each share similar attributes to the Greco-Roman gods Zeus, Poseidon, and Hades respectively. El is the gray, bearded ancient one, full of wisdom, Malku, king, father of years, El the warrior.
He is creator eternal, the epithet Elam appearing in Hebrew form, in the Hebrew name of God Elam, God eternal, in Genesis 21.33. El is called again, and again Toru El, Bul El, or the Bull God, creator of creatures, father of the gods, father of man. El or Elo, the Bull God, the father of humankind and all creatures, and the husband of the goddess Asherah, as recorded in the clay tablets of Ugarit.
The Sistine Chapel is the best known chapel of the Apostolic Palace, the official residence of the Pope, in the Vatican City, in Rome. It is the home of the Catholic faith.
Michelangelo is suspicious that such a large-scale project was being offered to him by enemies as a setup for an inevitable fall.
The following images of the painting, The Creation of Adam, by Michelangelo, in the Sistine Chapel. Notice anything strange? I thought Jesus of Nazareth the Christ was the only begotten Son of God, in the Catholic faith. Is it El, his wife, and their children, who are painted in the Sistine Chapel?
The theological position of the Tanna is that the names El and Elohim, when used in the singular to mean the supreme and active God, refer to the same being as does the name Yahweh.
Yahweh is used in the Bible Tanna as early as Genesis 2:4. Genesis 4:26 says that at that time people began to call upon the name of the Lord. It seems almost certain that the God of the Jews evolved gradually from the Canaanite El, who was in all likelihood the God of Abraham. If El was the high God of Abraham and Elohim, the prototype of Yahweh, see 2 Kings 23:15.
I revealed myself to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob as El Shaddai, but was not known to them by my name, Yahweh. Exodus 6:2-3. Then God said to Abraham, Take your son, your only son, whom you love Isaac, and go to the region of Moriah. Sacrifice him there as a burnt offering on a mountain I will show you. Genesis 22.
In Hebrew, El is a generic word for God that could be used for any god, including Baal, Moloch, Yahweh. First Chronicles 12:5 mentions the name Baalia, more accurately Baalieh, meaning Yahweh's Baal. Since Baal simply means master, there is no obvious reason for which it could not be applied to Yahweh as well as other gods. In fact, Hebrews generally referred to Yahweh as Adonai, my Lord, in prayer.
From what we can tell so far, El, Elohim, Yahweh, and Baal are the same god. But what about Moloch?
Moloch, M-L-K, a Semitic root meaning king.
As a god worshipped by the Phoenicians and Canaanites, Moloch had associations with a particular kind of proprietary child, sacrificed by parents. In the Old Testament, Gehenna was a valley by Jerusalem, where apostate Israelites and followers of various Baalim and Canaanite gods, including Moloch, sacrificed their children by fire.
The following images are depictions of the god Moloch. Notice anything familiar?
The following picture is of the horned altar, found in Beersheba, which was used for animal sacrifice, in the Temple of Jerusalem, 1st century AD. When the stones were reassembled, they formed a cubical altar with four tapered projections or horns. One of the stone blocks had a snake carved onto it. The top stones were blackened, suggesting that sacrifices had been burnt there.
Yahweh is a jealous God, for thou shalt worship no other God, for the Lord, whose name is jealous, is a jealous God. Exodus 34:14. All the earth shall be devoured with the fire of my jealousy. Zephaniah 3:8. Yahweh is an unjust God. If thou refuse to let him go, behold, I will slay thy son, even thy firstborn. Exodus 4:23. Yahweh is a bloodthirsty God. I kill. I wound. I will render vengeance to mine enemies. I will make mine arrows drunk with blood, and my sword shall devour flesh. Deuteronomy 32:39-42. Yahweh is a genocidal God. Thou shalt surely smite the inhabitants of that city with the edge of the sword, destroying it utterly, and all that is therein, and the cattle thereof, with the edge of the sword. Deuteronomy 13:15. Yahweh is a racist God. The Lord thy God hath chosen thee to be a special people unto himself, above all people that are upon the face of the earth. Deuteronomy 7:6. Yahweh is a child murdering God. Happy shall he be that taketh and dasheth thy little ones against the stones. Psalm 137:9. Yahweh is a cannibalistic God, and ye shall eat the flesh of your sons, and the flesh of your daughters shall ye eat. Leviticus 26:29. Let's now contrast the teachings of Jesus of Nazareth to those of Yahweh.
A new command I give you, love one another. As I have loved you, so you must love one another. By this everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you love one another. John 13:34-35.
I often wonder if the followers of Yahweh ever consider that they might be worshiping something that may be masquerading as a god. Or perhaps, because they are chosen and special, they are blinded by the light.
El, the bull god, Elohim, Yahweh, Bel, and Moloch worship, are often represented with a horned hand sign, representing a bull or ram. shall not bow down to them or worship them, for I, the Lord your God, am a jealous God, punishing the children for the sin of the parents to the third and fourth generation of those who hate me. Exodus 25.
We have both the god Yahweh, Baal, and Moloch requesting parents sacrifice their children by fire, but what about El, the patriarchal god of the Phoenician and Canaanite religion? Philo of Byblos was a Greek writer, whose account Saint Junithan survives in quotation by Eusebius, and may contain the major surviving traces of Phoenician mythology. Eusebius of Caesarea, through whom Saint Junithan is preserved, explains that El slew his own son Saudito, and that El also beheaded one of his daughters, later, perhaps referring to the same death of Saudito. Eusebius states, but on the occurrence of a pestilence and mortality, Cronus offers his only begotten son, as a whole burnt offering to his father Sky, and circumcises himself, compelling his allies also to do the same. Cronus circumcises himself. Cronus then, whom the Phoenicians call Elaz, who was king of the country, and subsequently, after his decease, was deified as the star Saturn, El, Toruel, Bolel, Elohim, Baal, Moloch, Yahweh, Elaz, Cronus, Saturn.
Humans have worshipped the planets and stars since the dawn of civilization, especially the planet Saturn. Saturn is the sixth planet from the Sun, and the second largest planet in the solar system, after Jupiter. Named after the Roman god of agriculture, Saturn, its astronomical symbol represents the god's sickle. Saturday is the day of the week following Friday and preceding Sunday. Saturday is the seventh and therefore last day of the week according to many commonly used calendars, but it is the second to last sixth day of the week according to ISO 8601. The Romans named Saturday Dies Saturni, Saturn's day, no later than the second century for the planet Saturn, which controlled the first hour of that day, according to Vettius Valens. Saturn is also known as Lord of the Rings.
Since Voyager 1, scientists have been baffled by the storms on Saturn's North Pole and South Pole. A persisting hexagonal wave pattern around the North Polar Vortex in the atmosphere at about 78 N was first noted in the Voyager images. The straight sides of the northern polar hexagon are each approximately 13,800 kilometers, 8,600 miles, long, making them larger than the diameter of the Earth. The entire structure rotates with a period of 10 hours 39 minutes 24 seconds, the same period as that of the planet's radio emissions, which is assumed to be equal to the period of rotation of Saturn's interior.
Saturn is the sixth planet from the Sun. Saturn Day is the sixth day of the week, and Saturn has a six-sided hexagon on its northern pole. 666. A hexagon can easily be turned into a hexagram star shape.
Oddly enough, the number 6 appears in a hexagram 9 times, and a hexagram itself equals 666.
HST imaging of Saturn's south polar region indicates the presence of a jet stream, but no strong polar vortex, nor any hexagonal standing wave. NASA reported in November 2006 that Cassini had observed a hurricane-like storm locked to the South Pole that had a clearly defined eye wall.
Oddly enough, placing the image of Saturn's North Pole and South Pole together, we get the following image. The following image is of the talisman of Saturn, used in ritual magic and Jewish Kabbalah. Note the sickle in the pentagram and the bull in the hexagram. El Toel, Bolel, Elohim, Baal, Moloch, Yahweh, Eliz, Cronus, Saturn.
In Sumeria and Babylon, the god of agriculture was called Ninurta. Ninurta was represented by the planet Saturn, and is the same god as the Phoenician El. The following images are of the Sumerian cylinder seals of the god Ninurta. Note the solar system image in the upper left corner with the hexagram encompassing a planet, the scythe next to Ninurta, and Rem in the lower right. Rams were often used in sacrifice to Saturn. The Romans worshipped Saturn as a god of agriculture also, as did the Greeks before them. Saturnalia occurred near the winter solstice because the sun enters Capricorn, the astrological house of Saturn, at that time.
Saturnalia was an ancient Roman festival in honor of the deity Saturn, held on December 17 of the Julian calendar, and later expanded with festivities through December 25. The holiday was celebrated with a sacrifice at the Temple of Saturn, in the Roman Forum. A public banquet, followed by private gift giving, continual partying, and a carnival atmosphere that overturned Roman social norms, gambling was permitted, and masters provided table service for their slaves. The popularity of Saturnalia continued into the 3rd and 4th centuries AD, and, as the Roman Empire came under Christian rule, some of its customs may have influenced the seasonal celebrations surrounding Christmas and the New Year.
In Roman mythology, Saturn was an agricultural deity who reigned over the world in the Golden Age, when humans enjoyed the spontaneous bounty of the earth without labor, in a state of social egalitarianism. For how many years shall this festival abide? Never shall age destroy so holy a day. While the hills of Latium remain in Father Tiber, while thy Rome stands, and the capital thou hast restored to the world, it shall continue.
And like his predecessor El, the Roman god Saturn, or Saturnus, did not burn his children, however, he ate them instead.
Saturn's chthonic nature connected him to the underworld, and its ruler Dissipator, the Roman equivalent of Greek Plouton, Pluto in Latin, who was also a god of hidden wealth. King of the Saturnalia, he was appointed by Lot and has been compared to the medieval Lord of Misrule at the Feast of Fools.
No one can be certain when Jesus of Nazareth was born, but we can be certain he was not born in December or the winter solstice. We know that shepherds were in the fields watching their flocks at the time of Jesus' birth, Luke 2:7-8. Shepherds were not in the fields during December. El Toel, Bolel, Elohim, Baal, Moloch, Yahweh, Eliz, Cronus, Ninurta, Saturnus, Saturn.
It has been ever universally admitted by the order that to part Masonry and Judaism is impossible. In fact, to use a well-known axiom amongst us, Judaism is Masonry, and Masonry is Judaism. The Jewish Chronicle, December 20, 1867.
Masonry, like all the religions, all the mysteries, hermeticism, and alchemy, conceals its secrets from all except the adepts and sages, or the elect, and uses false explanations and misinterpretations of its symbols, to mislead those who deserve only to be misled, to conceal the truth, which it calls light, from them, and to draw them away from it. Albert Pike, Morals and Dogma, page 104.
The following image is of the Mount Eilat Masonic Memorial in Israel.
Note, the Masonic Memorial in Israel is the same image that is on the back of the US $1 bill, and that the memorial has the compass and square of Freemasonry represented on it.
A hex is a magical spell, usually with malevolent purposes such as a curse. Hexa is a prefix from the Greek word for six. In hexagon, a polygon with six corners.
During antiquity, the hexagram was a symbol for the Jewish kingdom. When this kingdom was conquered in AD 70, and, in fact, already some 100 years before that, the Jewish people began to spread throughout the world, as did the hexagram symbol.
Muslims refer to the hexagram as Solomon's seal. A pentagram is a five-pointed star shape. What we do know with all certainty is that the pentagram was the main ideogram and the logotype, or official seal of the city of Jerusalem, during the period 300-150 BC.
In European occultism, a reverse pentagram with two points projecting upwards is a symbol of evil and attracts sinister forces because it overturns the proper order of things and demonstrates the triumph of matter over spirit. It is the goat of lust attacking the heavens with its horns, a sign execrated by initiates.
In the book, Romanizing Baal, The Art of Saturn Worship in North Africa by Andrew Wilson, Wilson points out that the deity, Baal, is usually represented by a crescent moon at the top of the stele. Sometimes a rosette or sun symbol, also of celestial significance, may appear.
Baphomet is a term originally used to describe a dark deity supposedly worshipped by the Knights Templar and subsequently incorporated into disparate occult and mystical tradition.
The arms bear the Latin word salve, separate, and coagula, joined together. Salve coagula, or salve coagulant, is a phrase used in ancient alchemy.
The five elements of alchemy are also represented by a pentagram. The Order of the Eastern Star is a free Masonic lodge for women. The following image is their emblem.
The ancient Pythagorean pentagram, with two legs up, represented the Pin Temichus. It was the island or cave where the first pre-cosmic offspring had to be put in order for the cosmos to appear, the divine products of Chrono seed.
According to the Hebrew Bible, Solomon's Temple, also known as the First Temple in ancient Jerusalem. During the Kingdom of Judah, the temple was dedicated to Yahweh, the God of Israel, and is said to have housed the Ark of the Covenant.
The following image is of the three Masonic columns. Note from left to right, the sun is on the first column, the all-seeing eye is on the middle column, and the moon is on the third column. Let's take the pyramid as the first clue, using it to reference the land of the pyramids, Egypt. Using this reference, let's see how Egyptian mythology refers to the sun and moon.
Intuitively, let's start with the moon, simply because it is on the highest pillar in the image of the three Masonic pillars.
Isis is a goddess in ancient Egyptian religious beliefs, whose worship spread throughout the Greco-Roman world. The symbol of Isis is the throne, the sun disk with cow's horns, and the sycamore tree. The celestial symbol for Isis is the moon.
Horus was born to the goddess Isis after she retrieved all the dismembered body parts of her murdered husband Osiris, except his penis, which was thrown into the Nile and eaten by a catfish.
Horus was the Egyptian god of war, sky, and protection. Horus' symbol was the wet jet eye. In later Egyptian dynastic times, Ra was merged with the god Horus. In one of his many forms, Ra has the head of a falcon, and the sun disk resting on his head. Ra was god of the sun.
Returning to the book, Romanizing Baal, the Art of Saturn Worship in North Africa by Andrew Wilson. Wilson goes on to write, 2nd century AD stele from Tim Gadol show many of the indicators of Roman influence we have already identified. The focus is still on the dedicant, but the deity makes more of an appearance. Saturn is now depicted more usually as a head than as a crescent symbol. The dedicants are shown in Roman dress and in postures typical of Roman religious monuments, sometimes making offerings at altars and framed within niches. With the exception of the simple composition of Legle 1966 APL 27.2, which is doubtless early and depicts only the lunar crescent symbol for Saturn and the sacrificial offerings, many stelae are inepigraphic, but where inscriptions do appear, they are simple dedications to Baal, giving the name of the dedicant and recording that he or she has paid their vow or made a sacrifice. The overall composition may also become more elaborate, as in Legle 1966 APL 27.4, with three registers: Saturn, the Sun, and the Moon in upper celestial register.
Saturnalia is a festival of light leading to the winter solstice, with the abundant presence of candles symbolizing the quest for knowledge and truth. The renewal of light and the coming of the new year was celebrated in the later Roman Empire at the Dies Natalis of Sol Invictus, the birthday of the unconquerable sun, on December 25th.
The father of the Egyptian goddess Isis was Jeb. Jeb was the Egyptian god of the earth and a member of the Ennead of Heliopolis. It was believed in ancient Egypt that Jeb's laughter were earthquakes and that he allowed crops to grow.
Jeb, Egyptian god of agriculture. Jeb was frequently described mythologically as father of snakes. One of the names for snake was S3-C3, son of the earth.
As time progressed, GEB became more associated with the habitable land of Egypt, and also, as one of its early rulers. As a Chthonic deity, he became naturally associated with the underworld, and with vegetation.
One of his otherworldly attributes was an ominous jackal, headed stave rising from the ground onto which enemies could be bound. The oldest representation in the fragmentary relief of the god Jeb was as an anthropomorphic bearded being accompanied by his name.
In later times he could also be depicted as a
ram, bull, crocodile,
Jeb is also equated by classical authors as the Greek Titan Cronus. Cronus then, whom the Phoenicians call Elaz, who was king of the country, and subsequently, after his decease, was deified as the star Saturn. Elaz, Toruel, Bolel, Elohim, Baal, Moloch, Yahweh, Cronus, Nanurta, Saturnus, Jeb, Saturn.
Gentile masonry blindly serves as a screen for us and our objects, but the plan of action of our force, even its very abiding place, remains for the whole people an unknown mystery. The Protocols of Zion, 4:2. For a more detailed analysis of the Israeli-Jewish involvement on 9/11, I recommend 9/11, Missing Links, full movie, on YouTube. There are also vast amounts of literature that has been written on this subject.
New World Order Pledge to Jews. Arthur Greenwood of British War Cabinet sends message of assurance here. Writing of wrong scene. English rabbi delivers to Dr. S.S. Wise new statement on question after war.
Noahide Law 1:1. Prohibition of idolatry. You shall not have any idols or false deities. Noahide Law 2:2. Prohibition of blasphemy. You shall not curse the name of Yahweh.
Was the ritual murder of 9/11 directed at El, Elohim, Yahweh, via a planet dint, or planetary event, for the planet Saturn? The following is an excerpt from the film, Saturn, Synagogue of Satan 3, The Brotherhood of Saturn, created by YouTube user, The Signs of the Time.
Get ready to read all these words on this page without making a mistake. Look at the letter at the end and remember the sound it makes. Get ready.
Kite.
Yes, kite. Get ready to read this word the fast way. Get ready.
Kite.
Yes. Sound it out. Get ready.
Kite.
Sound it out. Get ready.
Kite.
What word?
Kite.
Yes, kit. Boys and girls, sound this word out. Get ready.
Eagle.
What word?
Seal.
Yes, still. Read these words the fast way. Get ready.
Play.
Yes, play. Get ready.
Must.
Yes, must. Let's read these words the fast way without making a mistake. Get ready.
Kite.
Yes, kite. Get ready.
Kick.
Yes, kick. Get ready.
Steal.
Yes, steal. Get ready.
Playing.
Yes, playing. Get ready.
Must.
Yes, must. Go ahead and pick your reader up from under your seat. Open your book up to lesson 60 on page 153. Count of three, everyone should be on page 153. If the yellow paper is going to bother you, drop it. Thank you. Everybody touch the title of your story. Fingers under the title. Get ready to read the title, The Fast Way. We're waiting for one member. Thank you. Fingers under the title of the story. Get ready.
The
cat go. Yes, the cat go. Fingers on the. The cat go. Fingers on the first word of the story. Get ready to read the story the fast way. Get ready.
The girl had a cat go.
Go on.
She liked to go running with her
tail. Go on.
She played with her
tail. Try it again. Get ready from the beginning of that sentence. Get ready.
It is interesting to note that all the children were of African descent in the classroom with President Bush. Many Jews believe that blacks were created by God to be their slaves, via the curse of Ham.
The relevant narrative occurs in the book of Genesis and concerns Noah's drunkenness and the accompanying shameful act perpetrated by his son Ham, the father of Canaan, Gen 9:20-27. The story's original objective was to justify the subjection of the Canaanites to the Israelites, but in later centuries, the narrative was interpreted by some Jews, Christians, and Muslims as a curse of and an explanation for black skin.
And no one puts new wine into old wineskins. For the old skins would burst from the pressure, spilling the wine, and ruining the skins. New wine is stored in new wineskins so that both are preserved. Matthew 9:17.